Welcome to Bad Gear, the show about the world's most hated audio tools. Today I wanted to take the opportunity to thank you for being part of that beautiful monster this channel has become. Your support and ideas make all this possible. After the release of the 10k subscriber special last week, a lot of people asked me whether I can give a little glimpse into how to set up a setup like this with all its MIDI and audio connections. I will also talk about strategies for not getting lost when playing a table full of ill-reputed equipment in bright sunlight. There's a lot to do, so let's get right to it.
The most important thing when playing an electronic live set is pushing the right buttons at the right time. I can't help you with that, but having a well-prepared and flawlessly working setup gives you the freedom to focus on doing exactly that. First of all, choose gear that goes together well. I didn't have much choice because I'm the bad gear guy, but fortunately most of the stuff was easy to mix. There is a rather hard cut in the middle of the jam because I found it difficult to combine the more acid-oriented sounds with the straightforward techno banger of the Akai Animals. Almost equally important, find the right place for the gear. Everything you need for a certain section in your set should be within your reach. That sounds logical, but is easily messed up. Let's start with MIDI. I used three independent MIDI chains. One MIDI out of my audio interface split with the MIDI Solutions Quadra through, providing MIDI clock to most of the instruments. Another clock-only chain fed from my MIDI controller was going out to the instruments in its direct proximity, and the second MIDI output of the interface was used for sequencing the Red Sound Darkstar and keeping the Alesis SR16 in line. As you might already know, MIDI clock is the tool of choice if sequencers, synth, groove boxes, drum machines and effects units should be in time. The Darkstar was the only instrument without an internal sequencer, so it got the note information from the computer. Oh, I almost forgot about my two favorites. The Microkorg and the Yamaha DJX2B are played by hand, so no MIDI, just audio. Every MIDI chain and most of the split subchains make use of classic daisy chaining, where the signal is passed from the MIDI through of an instrument to the in of another. Not all instruments have MIDI throughs, and I wouldn't use more than three of them in a row. There are various reasons not to use a conventional mixing console. They use up a lot of space and there are many convenient DAW features that are difficult to recreate on a low or mid-budget analog mixer. I was using Ableton Live as a digital mixing console, multitrack recorder and effects rack, controlled by my trusty and unfortunately discontinued Evolution UC33. For safety reasons, I set the buffer size of the very reliable RME Fireface 400 interface to 256 samples. The little Fireface doesn't have a lot of analog inputs, so I connected a Focusrite Octopre LE via aided light pipe as an additional front end. It doesn't sound very good, but it's okay for a live situation. The 15 input channels and 2 stereo output feeds are managed, recorded and processed using just this. Connecting audio is straightforward. Everything is hooked up to the interface. The Darkstar and Volker beats were processed with the Behringer Virtualizer FX and Alesis 3630 compressor before they hit the input of the Fireface. The setup was mostly mono, only the MC303 got its own stereo channel. Providing power to a setup like this can be a major pain in the behind. Everything is great if you have the original power supplies. If you don't, you have to take the following parameters into account. AC or DC. Never mix this up. There is a risk of seriously damaging your gear. Voltage. As a rule of thumb, there should be an exact match between the power supply and the piece of gear you are using. Amps. The power supply must provide at least the amount of current the piece of gear is asking for. It shouldn't be a problem if the power supply provides more current. If it's not printed on the gear, take a look at the manual. When using DC power supplies, is the center of the plug positive or negative? And, last but not least, am I using the right plug? I built a prototype of the setup in my apartment and documented all connections. Otherwise, I would have lost a lot of time during setup on the roof. I had a rough idea what I wanted to play and assigned the controls of the UC33 in a way that would guide me through the set. From the lower left corner, I went full circle with one big transition that was managed using Ableton Live's crossfader. The main issue was sunlight. All that gear was obviously designed for basement use only. It is really hard to see the LEDs and read the displays in a bright environment. Especially when using the Akai drum machines, I had to memorize every move because it's not always easy to tell by ear which drum voices are currently playing. The tiny Line 6 Spider amp was used as a small PA system so Raimund, Snu and all the neighbors could hear what I was doing.
Strictly speaking, this is not a DAW-less setup, but I didn't touch the mouse or computer keyboard while playing and there was no need to take a look at the laptop during the set. There is only one thing that really bothers me. I didn't find a way to integrate the Korg PSS50 super section into the setup. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed the episode. Feel free to like and subscribe and don't forget to leave a comment what other kind of gear you would like to see and hear on the show.